Well, it's time for me to trim this tree behind me again. And what I have is one of these cutters on a pole. And you pull the rope. The problem is you can only cut a branch about so much in diameter. Some of these branches are much thicker than that. I'm going to need a saw. So this just came in the mail. It's an electric chainsaw on a pole. And it's made by Sunjo. I have other things around here from Sunjo. I was really happy. So when I decided to spend some money, I thought I'd buy this. I bought it online for $50, which is an awesome price. So frankly, it only has to do an okay job. So let's unbox this thing. First thing I see is you need to put oil in it. Well, I certainly hope some came in this box because I don't have any. I have to go to the store. Next thing I see is this adjustment here, which I think I'm probably going to be happy with. You can tilt it. I don't have the blade on yet. That looks like the only thing I have to do. To extend it, you flip that out. And right away, you know, that's a little bit heavy, but if I'm doing it straight up, that feels pretty good. And if I'm going to be doing this straight up, then it's good. Earlier I said that I paid $50 for this. It was actually $60. I paid the extra $10 to get this feature here. Without even test driving it yet, I figure that's an important thing to pay the extra $10 for. So let's see what is in this box. We got a tool. Got a sheath. Okay, we got a chain. Now I did a quick read of the instructions. It said to pop off this cap. Take off this nut. Okay, this screw here we're going to adjust later, but basically we just put this thing on. So what your goal is you're going to have the chain on it like that. The chain's going to go around this, and this little hole is going to go in there. So right away, see a problem, not really a problem, it's just a detail, is the chain's not long enough. I've got to move this whole thing like that. This is all about tightening when you have the chain on, you're all done. So, I will just move this down near the end. Little grooves in there. Now this is the first time I'm actually doing this. So it's not like I practiced 3 or 4 times. Okay. Let's see. This would go back on like this. And that goes on cap on, and now we tighten it. Okay, and this is all about turning this until the chain is tight. This is in the manual. You don't want it sagging. You want it taut.
but not so tight that you can't do this. Now this can get a little sharp, so you gotta be careful. As you can see, I can turn that, so this should be good. And we're back to oil. Can't fire it up today because I don't have any. I'm gonna have to go to the store. So it's time to wrap this up. We will put the sheath on it and make it safe. That wasn't hard. That was not hard at all.
So it's a day later and I got some oil. I think the important detail here is that you cannot put ordinary engine oil into a chainsaw like this. You need to use, it's called bar and chain oil. Cost about $5. In the next video, I'm going to test drive it and then let you know what I think.